Hey everyone, welcome back to this lecture on numbers in Python. We already briefly mentioned that there's two main number types that we're going to be working with throughout the course, and that is integers, which are whole numbers, and floating point numbers, which are numbers of a decimal. We're going to be exploring a little bit of basic math with Python, and then we'll also discuss how to create variables and assign them values. Let's open up a Jupyter notebook and get started. All right, so before we actually start typing any code, I wanted to briefly mention that if you ever want to toggle this toolbar or this header on or off, you can just come here, click view, and then select toggle header or toggle toolbar to turn them on or off. And typically during the lectures, I'll have them off, so we have as much space for coding as possible. Let's start off by just going over some basic math, which is pretty straightforward, and it's basically just using Python as a calculator. If you want to do addition, it's just an addition sign or a plus sign, 2 plus 1. If you want to do subtraction, that's just a dash or a minus sign, 2 minus 1. You can use an asterisk for multiplication, so 2 times 2. And if you want to perform division, that's just a forward slash, so 3 divided by 2 is 1.5. Okay, now let's take a little bit of time to discuss a mathematical operation that you may not have seen before. It's the modulo or mod operator. And basically what this does, it returns back the remainder after a division. For example, if we were to do 7 divided by 4, we get back 1.75. And if you were to do this kind of using elementary school mathematics, you would say 7 divided by 4, 4 goes into 7 one time with a remainder of 3, because 4 plus 3 is 7. Let's imagine you actually just wanted to know that remainder, the actual number 3. In that case, you can use the mod operator, which is a percent sign. So we're going to say 7 mod 4, and it returns back 3, because 7 divided by 4, it goes in one time evenly with a remainder of 3. So for example, we could do 50 mod 5, and if 5 goes into 50 evenly, then we get back a remainder of 0, which is nice because it's a way to check if a number is evenly divisible by another number. That's a really convenient check when you want to check if a number is even or not. So let's imagine we have an odd number, 23, and we want to know if it's even or odd. Well, I could just look at it, but maybe sometime in my code, it's disguised as a variable, and I really need to quickly check if it's even or odd. One way I could do this is simply with a mod 2. And I know that if mod 2 results in something other than 0, then we have an odd number. Because if I have an even number, then when you divide it by 2, there should be no remainder, or the remainder should be 0. So that's the mod operator. Again, it just gives you back the remainder after you perform a division. Let's continue with everything else about arithmetic. You can also perform powers. So you can do something like 2 to the power of 3. So that's just 2 asterisk signs in a row. So 2 to the power of 3, that's 8. And then we can also perform order of operations. Let's imagine that I have the following equation. 2 plus 10 multiplied by 10 plus 3. If I run that code, I get back 105. But what if I wanted to actually have 2 plus 10 occur first, then multiply that by the result of 10 plus 3? Right now, we're following basic order of operations with math, which is going to perform this multiplication first before it does this addition. So it's performing 10 times 10, 100, plus 2, plus 3. So to have our operations happen first the way we want them, we can use parentheses. I can say 2 plus 10 multiplied by, and in parentheses, 10 plus 3. And if I run that, I get back 156 the way I want it. Okay, so that's the basics of arithmetic and using Python as a calculator. Hopefully it was pretty straightforward. Coming up next, we're going to expand on this by showing you how you can perform variable assignments. That is to create your own variable name and then assign an object to it. We'll see you there at the next lecture.